بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله ثم أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Welcome back again to a roadmap to a successful Ramadan إن شاء الله تبارك وتعالى. Point number two: set your goals and set them high. Every single Ramadan, we set goals for ourselves. Are you one of those people who always want to finish the Quran only one time or do one khatma of the Quran? Do you think you can achieve 10 khatmas during the month of Ramadan to recite the Quran from cover to cover? Well, I know people who can achieve that. And I know people who have done even more than this. So it depends on your goals. That's how much you achieve. When you set your goals, you need to set them very, very, very high. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, وَسَارِعُ وَسَابِقُ وَفِي ذَلِكَ فَلْيَتَنَافَسُ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ. He says, سَارِعُ, which means you need to rush, سَابِقُ, vie and compete. And he said, وَفِي ذَلِكَ فَلْيَتَنَافَسُ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ. And in this, which means in for the Akhirah, for the world of the Akhirah, for Al-Jannah, let those who vie and compete, let them compete. Why is that? Because the price for what you're doing, the price for the goals that you set for yourself is Al-Jannah. And that is paradise. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala set Al-Jannah so high. So, أَلَا إِنَّ سَلْعَةَ اللَّهِ غَالِيَةَ أَلَا إِنَّ سَلْعَةَ اللَّهِ الْجَنَّةَ. The price for what you do is Al-Jannah. It is a very, very expensive price. So you're going to have to pay for that. And you're going to have to make it very high and lofty, inshallah, tabaraka wa ta'ala. When the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was on Bay'at al-Aqaba, when he met with the Sahaba, the Ansar, radiallahu ta'ala anhum, during the Hajj, in order to facilitate his hijrah and his arrival to Medina, radiallahu ta'ala anhum, the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he asked them what can they offer for him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, of protection and help and assistance and making Medina his hometown. In return to that, what did he offer them, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? He said, لَيْسَ لَكُمْ ثَمَنْ إِلَّا الْجَنَّةِ. The price you get from me is Al-Jannah. That's of course from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But he set the price so high for them. So based on that price, this is how high your goals are going to be. If your goals are only to lose weight, if your goals are only just to do the bare minimum like everybody else does and socialize and so forth, most likely you will have a very, very actually low standard when it comes to goals. But if your expectation or if your reward and if your aim is to get to Jannat al-Firdaus, your goals are going to be very, very, very high and lofty. So what plan do you have? What goals do you have? You need to plan something such as finishing the Quran 10 times, for example, within 29 days of the month of Ramadan. Divide that on the hours and the days and the nights of the month of Ramadan. You need to set goals such as achieving and praying Taraweeh, every single Taraweeh, inshallah, in the masjid, that you would not miss that. You need to make a plan and make a goal, inshallah, ta'ala, to pray Jama'ah in congregation, almost every Salah if you can afford that. Not missing Salat al-Isha, and as a matter of fact, Takbiratul Ihram for Salat al-Isha in the masjid instead of coming late all the time. And you need to achieve so many other good khairat and good deeds. But the point is, whenever you set a goal for something good to do in Ramadan, make it high as possible, knowing that your reward for this is also lofty and high. That's Al-Jannah. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.